I think our service is the expression of our identity and mission, loving service to the poorest of the poor. That's why we cannot help but be committed to justice and peace, to work in the peripheries, because we have to go where others do not go. I think that's what is very important for us, especially in Mindanao. Daughters of Charity is an institute of apostolic life without religious vows. And we live out our constitution according to the three normal vows of the religious. What makes us different is that we have a fourth vow. Aside from chastity, poverty, and obedience, our fourth vow is service of persons who are poor. And the three vows are actually to achieve this purpose of service to persons who are poor.
In many ways, they have been helpful in helping in the working in the peripheries that Pope Francis calls us to work in. Here in Cagayan de Oro, they have also been focusing on the migrant workers apostolate, and they have been able to help organize families that have been left behind by the overseas Filipino workers. And they have been also working closely with the government agencies. So I think their openness and their helpfulness have been outstanding. Likewise, during the time of Typhoon Sendong, they were also very much visible. Their superiors sent four teams of about 15 sisters each, one at a time for about 1 or 2 weeks, and each of these teams were able to help in the relief and rehabilitation work of Typhoon Sendong affected families.
On our 150th anniversary, the Daughters of Charity offered 150 scholarships all over the Philippines, and some of them are from I think all of the communities in Mindanao also, two scholars each. And our scholars are children in Cagayan de Oro, are children of cargador in the pier, cargadores in the pier.
Di ay ni-ari din he, sa tong entina, lugay-lugay na. Mao na, kinsa tong dili makakaya pagpa-eskwila. Ang giuna nilag dool ang mga porter. Pero ako ato sa gayo na dili pa ko porter na mga ritunay. Kanya ang ilang priority ang mga bata sa porter. Mo tong patawag me gini kanan. Mo ni. Mo ang istorya. Mo na akong anak nakuha. Hangtod nga naka high school na siya. Dito na eksponsuran siya si Stella Mares. Hangtod nagagraduate. Dako kay kong pasalamat nila. Kay og dito mo dila di mo kay eskwela kong anak. Oh, pero di gatabang na ko. Kuan ganahan graduate na maestro. Para pasalamat sa Ginoo.
That is where the Daughters of Charity, the Vincentian Spirit, zeroes in on the quality of life for the person, for the one person, to look at the root of poverty and all forms of injustices, and to do things to lessen them, and yet also to look at the individual person, his very needs at the moment.
Here, you have sisters who are able to work for many years in difficult situations, and it's all because of their own concern for the poor and the marginalized. And in that sense, I think it is one way to show that peace and development can be carried out in Mindanao by ordinary people and by, you might say, communities that are willing to help.
Because I believe also, as the Ministry of Indigenous Peoples, the whole world is our classroom, and the whole world is our altar, wherever we offer ourselves for the service of the poorest.